Hey, welcome to Chairside Live. I'm Megan Strong.
And I'm Will Schmidt, registered dental assistant here at Gladwell Dental.
And in today's episode, we're wrapping up Dr. Muresan's three-part BruxZir Esthetic veneer case. We've gone from treatment planning to gingivectomies to the healing phase, and now it's the final phase. What's this all about?
That's right, and this is the fun part, Megan.
Yeah.
Dr. Muresan's gonna take a digital impression with the iTero Element scanner.
Yes, she is.
We're gonna try on these restorations, and then I get the privilege of assisting with the seat of these final, no-prep, BruxZir Esthetic veneers.
Sounds like a jam-packed show. Let's see it. Roll tape.
Welcome back again. Let's dive right into where we left off from the last episode. Patient is back now, 6 weeks after the laser gingivectomy. This case was a complete digital case from the scan, design, all the way to the mill final restoration. With the iTero Element intraoral scan, I obtain a digital impression. In the scan image, we can see the amount of gingival tissue I removed and the nice tissue response I got after 6 weeks. We can try in the restorations with water or with try-in paste. I feel that I have a better appreciation of the margin integrity if I just use water. After confirming the fit, function, and phonetics are good, we are getting ready for the bonding procedure. After the try-in, we decontaminate the intaglio surface from the salivary phosphates by using Ivoclean. We can see here Will is applying Monobond Plus to the intaglio of the veneer. This has MDP primer added to it. The metacrylate organic component of the primer will facilitate the formation of chemical bonds with the resin component of the cement. No preparation was done on this case, but in order to prepare the teeth for etch and bond, I pumiced the surfaces to take off the biofilm, then I sandblasted to remove the aprismatic enamel so I can obtain a more uniform etching pattern. Research shows that the aprismatic layer is interfering with the etching process, resulting in a lower resin adhesion. Sandblasting with 30 micron aluminum oxide prior to etching will achieve a favorable bond. This air abrasion caused the removal of 1 to 2 tenths of aprismatic enamel, exposing the prismatic layer, creating a more uniform, deep etching pattern. Of course, you can also do this just by touching the tooth with a flex disc, because we don't want to bond in unfavorable conditions, so rather sandblast, use a soft disc. Teeth were conditioned with adhesive after the application of the etch step. For this case, I chose Veriolink Aesthetic Luting Composite for the final set to ensure long-term color stability and ample seating time. The final no-prep veneers were seated sequentially with gentle finger pressure, starting at midline and move distally towards the second bicuspids. To ensure all layers of the cement are polymerized, I final cure each side for 20 seconds while applying pressure using wooden seating sticks. All the interproximal excess cement was gently removed with a serrated saw and floss. After removing all the excess, one last polymerization stage is performed after the application of the oxygen-inhibiting glycerin gel. Altering the gingival aesthetics using Picasso diode laser proved to provide a rapid tissue healing with beautiful gingiva and no post-op discomfort for the patient. These beautiful restorations are made of BruxZir Esthetic, which represents a new category of zirconia, pairing the high aesthetics required for the anterior zone with the durability sufficient for the posterior zone. With these 10 units no-prep BruxZir Esthetic veneers, I was able to address all patient concerns and put back the confidence in her smile and refresh this young professional's facial appearance. Thanks for watching. Back to you, Will and Megan.
Well, thank you so much for that, Dr. Muresan. Now, if you missed the first two episodes of this case, head on over to chairsidelive.com and get all caught up.
Well, that wraps it up for today's episode. So on behalf of everyone here at Gladwell Dental, thank you so much for watching.
And we will meet you right back here next time.
We will.